Welcome to H. Rodney Talks for the Superstars. Tonight, great guest, the incredible.
I don't think my there we go, my mic's on.
Yeah.
Oh shit, wait, who was that? Was that you, Willis?
Yeah.
Oh, bust it, nigga. I got a hot four. Yeah. Mike Robertson, Boulevard. If you in my place, then I pull your car. You on my street, but it ain't no cars. Nigga, I'm hard. Roar! Mellroz.
He hard, I'm harder too. Melly on the mic, nigga, fucking you. I'm chilling on the radio. Everybody know that I like a hoe. Oh!
Black Rosebud in the place to be.
First of all, y'all
Black
gotta
Rosebud
rap.
Black Rosebud in the place to
y'all
be.
Y'all rapping that old school shit. Do the beat again. I better tell you how to.
Oh, shit. Oh man, I didn't do my retarded voice.
Young baby.
Okay.
I do the battery, damn.
Oh, man.
That nigga trying to go platinum. That ain't fair.
That's that young thug. That's that new shit. Y'all ain't up. Y'all talking about that 90s shit. Y'all got
to
get up on that third
platinum.
Y'all talking about clarity.
He trying to drop a record.
Oh, my goodness.
Y'all talking about clarity. All right,
let me get at it. Hold on, wait. Let me get at it, man. I enjoy a fucking challenge. Look, Willis, do that shit again, but slower like them motherfuckers do. I got 100 guns in my car now, and I blast them in your face and go bow, and I kiss your girl in your face. I don't know,
you
man.
Getting there. You in the 2000s, nigga. You in the 2000s. You got to do some singing. It's an audio tune, nigga. Like you got cancer, nigga. Yeah. You got to pump with it.
Oh, man.
Mellroz, hit it, nigga. Mellroz, do the cancer. Do the bust the beef. Do it. You got to do the computer love beat.
Give me that shit. Give me that shit. And let me a dick, bitch. Let me a dick, bitch. Let me a dick, bitch.
You're doing that shit. Okay, coming
here,
out.
Here we go. Go real slow. Real slow.
I love all my girls on the bus.
Oh, this nigga trying to go platinum, man. Fuck Rosebud.
I love him on the bus.
This nigga freestyling. He giving his real records.
Yeah,
he
freestyle beat.
This nigga coming with his real records.
This nigga said the freestyle beat. This nigga went.
This nigga, yeah, man. You some type of, you be doing that shit at Venice Beach, nigga. Like a one-man band. Oh,
all you need
fuck.
I got that.
What's dude's name from, never mind.
That's Rodney Jerkins, man. I'm looking at him right now. That's fucking Rodney Jerkins up there.
Rodney
man.
King Jerkins. Ah, man, y'all fuckers are funny, man.
Sadney.
Much fuckers. Love. All right, look. We here at the end of January 31st, live on Mike Robertson Boulevard. We having fun tonight, and I got some great cast of characters, true professionals. Nobody knows what I'm gonna say before I say it, and you see how sharp these guys are in the place to be. Starting on the right,
what up?
The main man, the most what?
The most interesting comic in the world.
Mellroz Uncut.
Yes, sir.
That motherfucker's bad, baby.
Bam.
next to me,
like that.
To the left. What, a name like that?
Yeah.
This nigga use his government name and shit.
Motherfuckers be Googling me like, okay, I see where he lives.
He's also on LinkedIn.
Yeah. I was scared when he first told me his name. I'm like, I'm out of here. This nigga is a police.
Yeah, man.
This real name. Like,
I only got two syllables in both names. Nah, man, this is my homie Willis Turner in the place to be.
What's happening?
Yeah. Like,
Willis comedian. Beatbox Turner, what they call
him. Yeah,
nigga.
I see
wait,
him.
Wait,
beatbox.
What you beatboxing, Willis?
Willis Turner. He's a comedian. Funny guy, man. Catch that guy. Follow him everywhere. And then to the left, got another crazy person who just about will say anything and shit. We got Mr.
And about fuck anything, too. I would, not men, just women. I would fuck any type of woman.
Just about clarify.
Or certain animals.
Yes, they get the percentages right, motherfucker.
Because all drunk I am, certain animals.
All right, that's Mr. Black Rosebud.
Right.
Give it up to him. Cheers.
What the hell?
I don't even know what that was.
That was a clap,
nigga.
Okay.
Look,
that was stadium
and
shit.
What else y'all can't see
that.
Over there in the corner is Willis Turner's uncle, cool cat that
Cal.
Just came in from Texas.
He came in from Texas.
Man, if y'all can see his shoes, man, he's Stacy Adams out with the hat and the gold wristwatch and the ring. This motherfucker's
hey,
bad.
Last time I seen a pair of Stacy Adams like that, they was up a bitch ass. Man,
this nigga was a pimp, a pastor, and a stepfather. This nigga was all three of them.
And that's what he wore to get on the plane.
Yeah, dude.
Because that's his comfortable shit. Yeah.
He got that's a pocket full of Viagra right now. He gonna fuck the shit out of one of these
nigga
California bitches.
Slap you with a bag full of them, nigga. Just upside your head.
Hey, what's all this blue shit on my face?
He gonna fuck the shit out of one of these Cali bitches.
He said he got hoes. Look, he said his hoes, he don't have to touch no hoes. They do everything he want, dude. He got the mind games.
That's
what he said before
we got
on his radio.
That's that good pimping right there when you can just tell a bitch what to do. I got mind control over bitches.
Man, God
go to the moon if you ain't scared.
Baby.
I can't get my bitch to make a ham sandwich, nigga. You make them travel the world with you, nigga. That's,
yeah.
And make a bitch buy me a Popeye chicken dinner. And that shit is only $2.99. Like,
man, dude.
Like now, bitch, ABT won't buy me no food.
Nigga drive all the way to Vegas just for a buffet and shit. Eat all you want, baby.
Motherfucker won't even split an EBT card with me.
Ebit. Oh, man, what's happening this week? Super Bowl is coming up. Who y'all niggas rolling with, man? I'm fucking with Atlanta.
I'm rolling with Rush.
I'm rolling with Atlanta. I hope they come back with the Dirty Bird again and get busy on these fools, man. I mean, I'm a Dallas fan, so I've been dead for 2 weeks, but Atlanta, I'm rolling with you.
Oh, man, I want Atlanta to win, but I really don't want Atlanta to win because... You know what I'm saying? That's the home of the chocolate homosexuals. And, you know, I don't want to see no parade with no gang of gay dudes prancing down the goddamn street. Atlanta is home of the gay dudes.
They
don't want to see that. I don't want to see.
They got a different Dirty Bird.
They got a different, yeah. They got the filthy bird out there.
Hey, look, let me tell you this, right? Here, let me tell you this story. So I went to Morehouse College, right? Everybody know that.
Congratulations.
And, yes, sir. And I went back in the day. So, like... This is before video, before all that shit, right? I was out there, and niggas was in school, and I had never in my life seen a black transvestite before. Like, never, dude. And, you know, niggas see, like, Lil Richard or somebody right. like that on TV and shit, but you never really seen a real deal.
In face
so, nigga,
to face.
So back, Morehouse was, like, in ghetto territories and shit, and they had this street called Ashby Street, nigga, where these motherfuckers would
Wait,
be
Ash?
Out there and... Look, and they would try to be obviously men, like buff and yoke
oh,
and shit,
no.
but had like the little skirt on and a little tank top.
Oh, no, nigga.
So look, man. We was confused,
look
man.
Looked like a
so,
Russian gymnast.
Looked like a goddamn gargantua. Look, we rolled up and was like, somebody from the truck was like, you fucking freak or some shit. That motherfucker was like, y'all niggas better get on.
Oh, niggas kept pushing too, like.
The Morehouse, right?
Maybe you're right, sir. Ooh.
So you
taking a chance.
Nigga was
you might
like,
be right.
Oh, nigga,
fellas,
is that a tiger and shit?
So you've been to a freak, Nick.
Oh man, did have I been to a Freaknik, man? I'm one of the kings of the
Come
game.
Come on, man, I've never been. Explain, man.
This nigga is Nick.
Man, do you get it?
It was freaking. There was
man,
Nick.
Look, man.
Yeah, they call me Nick.
That's one thing I didn't get a chance to experience. You know what I'm saying? Explain.
Look. First of all, the Freaknik started off. Okay, the D.C. Metro Club started the Freaknik, which was niggas from D.C., Maryland, Virginia, right? That was the club at school. They literally started the motherfucking Freaknik, dude, when I was a freshman.
East Coast niggas started this.
Started it, right? As a little picnic, nigga, at the park. It's year number two, more all the other clubs came. The California Club.
Okay.
The New York Club. Everybody, Michigan Club. Everybody came. Dude, by year three, man, that motherfucker was lit.
Bananas?
Nigga, across the whole park, just, it was bananas.
Is it always called Freaknik?
It started at a park.
Was it always called Freaknik, or did that name derive after some wild shit happened?
Them D.C. niggas was freaky, man. That shit was always Freaknik,
They was
man.
Doing the butt from
Hell
day
yeah.
one.
Doing some go-go shit,
doing
man.
Doing the butt. Mm.
It was off the hook, though, man. And let me tell you, dude, it just grew into a whole citywide thing, and it grew into a whole citywide thing, and fools was just coming from everywhere for that shit, man. It was crazy, dude. It was wild, dude. You could go to jail with that motherfucker. You could lose your life. You could lose your sister or your cousin, man, and never see him again, man.
I only heard stories about the Freaknik. A nigga told me about some shit my baby mama did. That's my introduction to the Freaknik.
I got it, man.
A clicker.
Yeah, to open the gate.
Oh, I thought you meant a clicker for like a lighter or some shit. Like,
you could tell the smokers in the house. Like,
no, I'm retarded, nigga. I am high as midget pussy right now.
Click the gate closed, nigga. Keep the gate.
She said clicker. I'm thinking talking about a lighter. I'm thinking she finna smoke a cigarette or something. Like, nigga,
said, keep the gate closed.
Man, fuck, dude. I look. Lady Gaga's performing at the Super Bowl.
That's going to be the Freaknik.
Yeah, will she take her titty out, do a Janet 2 and shit, take both of them out?
That's the bitch who had the meat suit?
Yeah.
Yeah. That bitch had a meat suit. Was it pork chops and chicken? What was it?
Like lamb and a mix of lamb and turkey.
She didn't do that shit around no dogs, nigga.
Nah,
I know that.
Didn't.
She didn't do that shit in no goddamn projects either. They would have sold that bitch.
For the low.
Nigga would have had what's that bitch name?
Is that a meat vest?
Yeah, bitch, get that.
Lady Gaga was sold for food stamps over in the Nickerson Gardens this afternoon.
They'd have been rubbing their EBT card between her titties.
Damn, a T-bone purse and shit.
Ain't that bitch retarded or something? Ain't Gaga, she retarded white bitch. Like,
I don't know, man. She rich as shit, dude. Yeah, I don't know, man.
I only know white bitches if they sluts, if they go to jail, you know what I'm saying? Or if they made a motherfucking, went crazy or some shit. Like, Britney Spears, I know that bitch because she went crazy.
Right.
I know Paris.
Britney Spears went crazy for a minute, dude. She was over the wild side, dude.
I liked that bitch. You like crazy bitches got the best pussy, my nigga.
Look, the more trailer parks.
No barriers.
Have you ever fucked a crazy bitch in this? Like, what the fuck she didn't say to me? Like, this bitch just say shit like,
get the fuck off me, nigga.
Bitch scared me one time. She didn't, boo, boo, bitch, I'm fucking with this guy. Daddy. I'm like, bitch, I feel like a pedophile. Stop this shit.
Are you my daddy?
Like, stop.
Rosebud be like, yep, I'm your daddy.
I'm one of them, bitch.
You want a pacifier?
I'm baby daddy.
That's fucked up.
Baby papi.
Dude. One thing is tripping me out right now. Okay, everybody knows that we are now officially in this time where recreational marijuana is legal, but the shit don't feel no different, huh?
Recreational. Look,
I'm still scared to smoke weed.
Yeah, like you don't even trust the law and shit.
I'm like, nah, these niggas. Put that shit out. Take on the police.
Yeah,
that license don't mean shit. Put that shit up.
You know what's crazy? All this Trump is in there, nigga. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what's crazy? Remember, back in the day, you smoked some stress. You couldn't smoke the whole blunt. Used to smoke that shit, put it out, smoke something, put this shit out. Now you smoke a whole motherfucking blunt, want to smoke another one. You be like, I ain't high enough. I need to get more high.
Nigga, that shit is like repeat weed.
Nigga.
This
nigga said, you
know. Nigga said, that's tolerance.
I need to get more high.
Yes, motherfucker. In the beginning, yeah, it was
that's
rough
gateway,
on you.
That's gateway, my nigga. That's gateway. That's gateway. Something.
This shit ain't strong enough. Motherfucker.
I'm finna shoot this shit up.
This nigga.
Now you ain't got no liquid form of this?
Yeah, you ain't got no Visine weed, nigga. You can put it in my eyes.
Hey, you remember preparation for the weed back in the day? You had to take the stems out, the goddamn seed. You had to get a shoebox and slide them.
This nigga went to lock, y'all, so
yeah,
weed stories are going to be a little different.
Yeah, things are different
from your west
there.
Side, yes, niggas. Yes. Like,
you know I was considered the dumbest nigga in the world?
Why?
Because I was the dumbest nigga at the dumbest school, in the dumbest city, in the dumbest state, in the dumbest country. So technically speaking, you know,
damn,
technically,
nigga, you was a fipple OG.
I was
dumb
the
nigga.
Dumbest nigga in the world, nigga. That's you the dumbest nigga in the dumbest school, in the dumbest city, in the dumbest state, in the dumbest country, damn. Nigga. You the dumbest nigga in the world.
I beg to differ. I went to Jeff, nigga. We was.
Y'all went too far.
He said we was just as dumb.
I was like, shit.
Our shit was even ESL, nigga. Our shit was predominantly Spanish, nigga.
Hey, look.
At least y'all learned English, nigga. Our shit came in Spanish for us.
Hey, who is K Paso?
Hey, you know how, like, at high school they had a little, like, bungalow in the back for dumb niggas?
Yeah.
These niggas went to high schools with all bungalows, nigga.
I'm about to say, nigga, all my classes was in the bungalow.
Was a trailer, nigga.
You go to class like this, Rodriguez? Rodriguez? Rodriguez?
Lopez?
Washington?
This is a true story, right?
Absent.
My mama came to visit me when I was in jail, right? Mm-hmm. And the police was playing with people. They was, you know, they call you out and they like, okay, visit.
This nigga threw out jail like it was a job and shit. Like, nigga, my mom came to visit me
while I was in jail.
Yeah, while I was at Taco Bell.
That's
shit.
Like, you know, that's
and
like
in my lunch break. And shit.
You know, for black people, that's like some kind of you. That's like a passage to manhood. When you go, when you from the ghetto and you go to the
when
county.
When they took your manhood, what you say?
Nah, I took somebody's manhood, but okay. I'm just saying, look, we ain't here to talk about that. That's a nigga show.
I'm glad.
No, I'm talking about not like that.
This motherfucker just turned into an episode of Scared Straighter. Hey,
on that note, I've got to have a drink.
No, wait a minute.
You?
No, not me, personally. You know, cowboy fans, you know what I'm saying? Because they used to bet on their ass all the time because they used to make no money. So a lot of cowboy fans just get raped in prison. This is the bet on the Cowboys all the time.
Man. This nigga here, man.
So if you ain't got no money.
Hey, rewind that shit, man.
I heard a lot of stories.
Rewind that shit, man.
You ain't
welcome
got no
to
money.
Mike Robertson Boulevard, man. What's the fucking topic? This nigga taking us down a shitty slope.
Yeah, man. Well, you know what? It's time for a break anyway, like, man. God damn.
Nigga, you couldn't just bet a hand job?
Yeah, telltale.
I'm just going to jack you off with them noodles, my nigga. I ain't got them. I'm going to give you a hand job. You like Jergens or Vaseline or soap?
This nigga here. All right, look, man. Live on Mike Robertson Boulevard. We're going to take a break, play a song. We're coming right back, man.
Hello, my name is Elaine, and I'll be your tour guide through South Central Los Angeles.
How to survive in South Central? A place where busting the cap is fundamental. No, you can't find a shit in a handbook. Take a close look at a rap crook. Rule number one, get yourself a gun. A nine in your ass will be fine. Keep it in your glove compartment, cause jackers, oh, they love to start shit. Now if you're white, you can trust the police. But if you're black, they ain't nothing but beef. Watch out for the kill. Don't make a false move and keep your hands on the steering wheel. And don't get smart. Answer all questions. And that's your first lesson on staying alive in South Central, yeah. That's how you survive.
Hi, this is Elaine again. Are you enjoying your stay in South Central Los Angeles? Or is somebody taking your things? Have you witnessed a drive-by? Okay. Make sure you have your camcorder ready to witness the extracurricular activities on Blacks by the Police. So you and your family can enjoy this tape over and over again.
Rule number two, don't trust nobody, especially a bitch with a hook from dope and stolen merchandise. Read the terms, cause South Central LA is one big term. Wait for a brother like you.
Damn.
I love it. That beat, that alone just...
Ice Cube.
I got a question for you. Since we on some hood shit. No, we're not on rape no more. You know what I'm saying? I'm through with that. That was in my past life.
Jail tales.
What we talking about, what do they got more of in the hood, right? Do they got more little Mexican 99-cent stores, liquor stores, taco trucks or weed dispensaries?
Liquor stores still are the ruling king.
Easy call.
You say liquor stores?
Liquor stores.
Nigga, I saw 5 weed spots on one corner. Nigga, I ain't never saw 5 weed spots on the 5 liquor stores on the corner.
Damn, and those were just Girl Scouts and shit.
Those little kids,
Girl Scouts
nigga.
Are half a block away. Bitch.
Hey,
I
look.
Got them peppermint.
Yeah, I got them pepper weed. Hey, look, what about this Ice Cube song that just went off? Because, like, you know, that shit was How to Survive in South Central from fucking 20 years ago, dude. Yeah,
that's
still,
still the rules.
Them rules still apply,
still
huh? Rule number one, get yourself a gun, a 9, and your ass will be fine.
That's still
that
a rule.
It's necessary. Keep it in your glove compartment. Look, and look, rule number two, don't trust nobody, especially a bitch with a hooker's body.
wait a minute. Nowadays wow. They're not looking for 9 millimeters. Niggas are looking for 9 inches. These niggas gay. And nowadays, you can't trust a hooker body because it might be a man. I'm just letting you know right now.
He's taking us back to the
more gay shit,
nigga.
Dude, more gay jokes.
Progressive.
Are you still on parole, nigga? Is this like, are you keeping your practice up so that when you get back in, like, nigga, I'm ready.
Case some shit go wrong, nigga. What, you on your second strike?
Like, nigga, I'm ready to rape a nigga still, nigga.
I keep my Vaseline on my neck, nigga, just ready to just...
Don't trust no celly.
Especially a nigga
with a nigga body.
With a ring in his belly.
Hey, that was good.
Don't drop the soap, nigga. If you do, you lost all hope.
See?
You better have a rope.
Don't trust no Southgate. Especially these niggas that want some rape.
Don't trust.
See? Ain't talking about gay shit.
Don't take no noodles.
Ain't talking about gay shit fun.
Oh, no, nigga.
Oh,
this motherfucker, man. Let's keep moving.
Whoa, this
nigga called it fun, man. Damn.
I mean, talk about gay people.
Kill
fun.
A good joke, man.
Damn. Wow.
Oh, man. All right, look,
the truth will set you free.
Hey,
yeah, you got some things you want to share, man.
It'll set you free or lock you up.
Hey, man, was you telling jokes in jail?
Either way, he's straight. He like, fuck
wait a minute.
Yeah, was you telling jokes in jail?
Free me, lock
all
me
I
up.
Know is I'm going for Atlanta.
A what?
I'm going for Atlanta.
He did.
Oh, this nigga going for Atlanta again. I want to reap all the benefits of an Atlanta win.
Yeah. Nigga said he want a dirty beak.
Next topic.
Oh, donkey damn, this nigga's... All right, man, let's keep going, dude.
What's next, Mike?
Here's a little game for y'all, man.
Okay.
What would you rather?
All right.
What would you rather? Mm-hmm. What would you rather... Would you rather brush your teeth with a cactus plant or use it as a Q-tip?
I'm going to use it as a Q-tip.
Oh.
Yeah, because I ain't got to go all the way in my ear.
Oh, you use it as a Q-tip. Oh, yeah, niggas. Yeah. Oh, that was an easy one. I see I hit y'all with the easy one first. Now we get ill. What would you rather? Would you rather slap Mike Tyson's moms in the face right in front of them? In a closed room, okay. Or take the Rodney King beating.
I'm going to slap Mike Tyson's mom in the face. I don't even think that nigga liked his mama.
Yeah. That nigga wasn't even raised by me. Like, fuck that bitch. She gave me up.
I would slap the shit out of Mike mama and explain to him what happened.
Mike, she said, fuck you.
Yeah.
Mike, she said, fuck you. That's why I slapped her ass.
I was trying to get her. I was trying to get your name out of her mouth.
Look, Mike, I saw
looking
a fly.
Looking out for us, man. Looking out for us, Mike.
She talking about whooping your ass when you was a kid, man. That shit pissed me off, Mike. I slapped the shit out of her, man.
She didn't love you, man.
Everybody the king, nigga, I'm still hurting from that one. And I wasn't even taking it.
She said, Don King was the best thing that ever happened to you, Mike. Like, that's why I slapped her like that, man.
The did you hear the way I say, bitch?
Look, look, even if Mike get mad, you can fight back with Mike. You can't fight back with five Billy Club and the police.
You do have a chance. Right. You do have a chance.
Have a chance.
That nigga might slip and fall. Right. So.
You got a chance.
You can bite a nigga. You can bite him. Bite, nigga.
Bite a nigga.
Five niggas ain't gonna slip.
They beat the shit out of Rodney. He didn't want no more problems. He said, can't we all just get along?
No retaliations, please.
Nobody else need this kind of shit. And I went through.
They know where I live,
that,
man.
They whooped the violence out that nigga.
That nigga kept on getting up and shit like, I like, stay down, nigga. This nigga is fucked up. You don't know the rule?
Nigga.
Oh, man. That nigga kept getting up, dude. It was like, he thought he was Rocky and shit.
Look, you know, everybody, look. Yeah. You know the look. Look, I've been watching how nigga people get knocked out, right? When white people get knocked out, they just go to sleep. They comfortable. They be snoring and shit. Yeah. When a nigga get knocked out, he get back up and
he get up quick. He get up quick. Back, back.
He want to make sure that nigga ain't finna hit him again. Right. Pow! Then he go sleep.
Get up discombobulated.
Get
I don't know, man. Niggas sometimes get hit and they get that extra adrenaline like, fuck that. I ain't going down like a bitch. Like, fuck that. I'm going down like a bitch.
Yeah, nigga, try to be as limp as possible.
I feel like it's a grizzly bear, nigga.
It's a certain way to fall out.
I play
though.
Dead, you gotta, nigga.
Oh, you gotta fall out right.
Yeah. Hey, like, speaking of would you rather, right?
That nigga said I play dead.
Hey, speaking of would you rather, right? Would you rather get knocked out by a transsexual or a woman?
A woman, nigga.
A woman?
Yeah.
A nigga ain't got no business fighting no transsexual. What the fuck we fighting about? Like, why we fighting?
Nigga, because we ain't at home together.
Oh, man.
That's more embarrassing, like, you know what I'm saying? To just get
embarrassing
knocked,
is getting knocked out by a transsexual.
You got to choose, though. You got to choose, though. What would it be?
A woman.
A woman?
A woman. A nigga can explain why my woman knocked me out.
Hey, I was in love, baby. I was in love.
I was cheating. She caught me. She socked me, and I fell out. Right. Now, why am I fighting a transsexual?
A nigga ain't gonna. Cause then I'm like, well, what if this nigga try to fuck me while I'm knocked out? Now my ass. I woke up with a sole jaw and a sole booty.
I'm taking full advantage.
Nigga, put the snicker on your chest like got him.
He's a mark. No, that's the right, embarrassing.
Here go another one, though.
No.
Okay. Here go another one. What would you rather?
What would you rather?
Would you rather come home?
Shit funny already.
I live my baby mama, so I don't want to ever go home.
Hey, look, would you rather come home and catch your wife fucking your best friend or your dog?
It depends on if my best friend came with some weed or something. My best friend came with some weed, I'd rather my best friend. If you got some weed, nigga. Because my baby mama and me and my baby mama, other baby daddy cool. So sometimes he leaves some weed and shit, like I pay him, I get my EBT check. So if my best friend has some weed, I go with my best friend.
These niggas got an arrangement already.
Look, my baby mama already fucked my dog, so that's you know, that's.
This nigga ain't even got no dog. He got cats.
Well, she fucked the cat.
It's hard, huh?
Yeah, I'm gonna say my best friend.
Because the dog,
I'm like, well.
The dog can't tell. The dog can't run around saying that, like, yeah, I fucked this nigga, bitch.
First of all, I don't want to be itching. Like, bitch, you gave me fleas. Like, you gave me fleas.
But the dog can't say nothing.
But that's what I'm saying.
The dog can't snitch. The dog can't tell the homies. The dog can't be on Facebook. Yeah,
a dog can snitch on the low.
You get
the
dog locked up.
Nigga, every time he come home, you come home, and nigga run over to your girl and be pointing to a pussy.
You can take the dog on the freeway and just let him go.
I'm going to say my best friend because my best friend is my wife, so I catch her fucking herself. It's
cool. Oh!
Oh, wow. That was great, man. I like that shit. Wow,
nigga,
man.
Well, my
special.
Best friend is my dog.
This nigga smart. You said you went to Jefferson, motherfucker.
You thought of that all fucking 5 minutes. He was like, I got a good one for this nigga. I'm finna hit him with this one.
He gonna be ready for this one, nigga.
He gonna fast forward. Hey, baby, watch this part right here.
Watch what I said about you.
Boom.
You're my best friend.
I love you. You better stop it right after.
Well, my baby mama is my worst enemy.
Why, dude? Why?
Why not? This bitch is
This nigga said, why not?
This bitch is evil, my nigga.
This bitch never put nothing on my books.
No, look.
Yeah.
I'm in there raping niggas. She ain't send a nigga no Vaseline.
First of all, she greedy, right? Like, okay. I was eating a sneaker the other day. She was like, you gonna eat the rest of that chocolate? I'm like, the chocolate on my fingers, bitch?
My
like,
skin?
No, you can't lick my fingers no more. Like, what the fuck?
Hilarious. Man, what's up with some callers, man? 323-293-3375. Come on, we got a caller.
Got somebody on the line.
Is it a hood rap?
Is it? Hey, let me ring this nigga in before we lose him.
Hopefully it's a hood rap.
Yeah, what up?
What up?
What up, player?
Big Buff from the low.
What's up?
AKA King Bear Sadat.
What up?
Hold up, man. You turning my homeboy on.
Yeah. You got a lot of cool names, man. They kind of cute shit.
Nigga, that sounds like prison names right there.
Yeah.
Now you just got my homie attention.
Yeah, Big Grizzly. It's like salmon eater.
Sally before, son. This nigga had a, like, big, hey, when you come to sell, like, my nigga, my name is Big Buff Nigga Swole.
Yeah.
You gonna sleep on the
He sound like he got a nigga in a headlock right now. Nigga.
Nigga, I thought I was calling the nigga on the left show, not the Mike Robertson Boulevard show. That nigga did
nigga,
a takeover on you.
Whoa, a makeover.
You said he did a makeover?
He did
what?
A takeover.
No, I said that nigga did a takeover work. You know all that gay shit talking about. Nigga, first of all, he went with the Falcons because it's too gay. Then he went back on the gay shit. Then redid the gay shit again.
This nigga's aggressive.
Hey,
we've been noticing that, though.
Yeah.
Look, we've been noticing that behind scenes. This nigga has had all gay comments.
That nigga do sound gay, though.
Nigga, I am thinking about every karate move I can think of with this nigga next to me.
Hey. Yo, you better do.
Hey, nigga, don't wear no deodorant and shit. Hey. Nigga, don't brush his teeth.
Hey, caller, I think that nigga is gay, though. That nigga be on some gay shit all the time.
Is this nigga?
Yeah, that's some funny
is this
shit,
nigga dude. Schizo and shit? What the fuck, dude?
Right. Like, we talking about you, nigga.
That nigga talking out of body.
Yeah, man.
This motherfucker, yeah, nigga. That nigga talking to himself, be in the mirror. Yeah nigga, you all know all that gay shit.
I heard that nigga be at the gay club with man. Them people, my nigga.
Hey, Buff, what would you rather, man? You heard the shit, right?
What's the last one?
What would you rather, dude? Look, would you rather come home and find your wife sleeping with your homie or your dog?
I can't even answer that, but when my man said, I don't even think Mike Tyson like his mama, that should have me dying, dude. Yeah, but, real quick, you was talking about Freak Nick.
Yes.
Y'all don't know y'all sitting next to a hero right there.
Man.
I don't understand your name, Nick.
Yo, dude, your man Mike came to my rescue one day back in the day. The whole fiasco happened. Mike Jive stole on his cat and ran off, dude. Yeah. That was a crazy story.
Hey, nigga, because I'm a veteran in the game, dude. Look,
you sock a nigga and leave.
Let me tell you, dude. This nigga was getting bum rushed by a group of niggas, man. And I was like, okay, so
like
how,
Dak
can
Prescott.
How can I help him but not be in the group and shit?
We're not trying to be a new addition.
I want
to
help but not help him.
Yeah, nigga, like.
This motherfucker came in. How can I be like FEMA?
Yeah, nigga, exactly. Right. Man, it came with funding and shit, nigga. Like,
let me get the distractions off of him.
Hey, so what happened? What happened? Describe the whole shit. What happened?
This nigga don't remember shit. He was on the ground.
I can say what happened, dude. The whole thing happened was we had some money in with these girls from Chicago to get some endo. To get coming to New York for us. Anyway.
See, I wasn't even a part of none of that. But look, I wasn't a part of none of that.
Hold up. But check it out. Hold up. So the whole thing happened, dude. It was a whole argument that happened. They said, no, some dude was a friend of hers, was on the football team. I
hell
just,
yeah.
For the first time, did a funnel with a grain on the top of it. Listen, I come up, it's a big squab. I don't even know what's going on. Then all of a sudden, nobody was around me.
It was DC niggas. It was DC fools, exactly.
Right.
Shook. That's when niggas was young, dude, and motherfuckers put up fists, and it was easy peasy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Took a Cali nigga to come through,
exactly,
sock him,
man,
and run.
That's how we get down.
West side. He did a west side sock by.
It was
nigga.
A sock by. It wasn't no sock and run, nigga. It was a sock by.
I need to go to DC. Hey.
I know how to step in, like, blah, blah, nigga. Right. Like, free my man, and then I'm out, nigga. Why would I take the L like that for nothing? Fool, I'm a veteran, man. In the,
you know? DC must be the business. I hear a lot about DC. DC must be the business.
Nah, them niggas wasn't playing. And then, dude.
You said they started freaking niggas, so they must be the business.
Oh, they
DC
business.
Niggas are crazy.
They are, dude.
They wilding out, like, for real.
I need to go out there with the dreads and shit, you know what I'm saying? All that shit. I need to go wild out and go go-go dance.
Nigga, you need a time machine
okay.
for that shit.
Okay.
Yeah, you need a time machine, go-go man. Dance. All right.
I think it's going back to some.
I just see this nigga.
All right, man. Thanks for calling, dog. Big Buff.
Big Buff.
Call next week, nigga.
Get word.
All right, man. That's Buff right there. All right, look, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back. Mike Robertson Boulevard and the place to be. Let's go, y'all.
Side sock by, nigga. Jerry Crow niggas kicking up dust. And some of them are even looking up to us. Wearing our colors and talking that gang fuck. Giving up much love. The engineer must be an Ice Cube lover.
I mean, after. After.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. The engineer's an Ice Cube lover. Nah, I told her to play it, but she was smiling when I told her, huh? Look, see, she like
the engineer is fine as a motherfucker.
Her name is Sky.
Sky?
Sky's the limit.
Hey man, she heaven must be missing the angel, man.
You heard all of my uncle all your whole life, huh?
Can you? Is my
she heard all them lies.
You know what? My baby
be coming with whackness, huh? Like Sky.
Oh, man. Sky. Well, I ain't never seen a cloud.
I
want to
fly
so
to friendly skies.
I just recently told my daughter, she told me, like, I told her, I was trying to give her a speech, and, like, I was told her, don't believe, like, when dudes tell her she's going to be fine when she get older, because she look like her mama. And her mama look like a boxer or MMA fighter.
Okay.
Or a linebacker for the Crenshaw Cougars.
I can recognize. Nobody lied to you.
I'm just saying, don't believe
you
with the men.
You told your daughter, hey, you know you're going
to
be ugly.
Yeah, you're going to be ugly. Don't believe the men when they say you're going to be fine. They're trying to get at you.
You saying you already ugly and you're going to stay ugly.
I don't lie to my daughter. Like, the other day, my baby mama was trying to tell her, like, these boys are only out for one thing. And I said, lie. I said, that's a lie. These niggas want some head, too. You know what I'm saying? It's don't want no. It's lying. Don't lie to my daughter.
All right, man, look.
He told her mama, nah, they want you to help move, push a truck down the street.
That's a Mexican family.
We need you.
All right.
All right, man, so we're going to do this little quick little scene today. The movie is Juice, right?
Juice.
So everybody know Juice when Pac got crazy and shot up all his fucking friends and he caught his homie Q
real nigga
in the hallway at the school. We about to do that scene.
Oh, that's my shit.
Damn, man, my phone just failed.
Nigga, you got to get a real phone. That Obama shit don't work up in here. We in a trap spot, nigga. You
nigga
got
said,
the Obama shit don't work in here unless they got you got their Wi-Fi connect, nigga.
You better get that Trump.
It's
phone.
The only nigga I know
nigga
got
right here.
Three Obama phones. It's like, nigga, how many programs you work. Signed up to, nigga?
Nigga got three Obama phones that say he ain't never done nothing for niggas. All right, look. All right, we about to do Juice. I'm Tupac, which is Bishop. Mellroz is Q. Willis is the narrator. Lights, camera, action.
Q stands alone at his school locker. Oh, shit.
Nigga got a call doing a script.
This nigga is my daughter.
Tell her she ugly. She got to fuck niggas and everything.
You ain't getting the job, motherfucker.
Hey, daddy's got to go. I'll call you back.
This.
I love you.
Oh, isn't that cute? She said, I love you too.
I want to call my son to tell him to go to hell. That's what I want to do. All right.
Man, don't corrupt this man's daughter, man.
Bye bye.
I said my son. My son is grown.
All right.
Your daughter ain't.
Okay, man. Let's do this over again. I'm sorry. Right. I haven't seen my. I hadn't got to say goodnight to my.
I ain't
daughter.
Seen my daughter all year.
Who the narrator?
You say?
Who the narrator?
I'm the narrator.
You got to do it with a deep voice, my nigga. You got to do it with the Samuel L. Jackson voice.
All right, here we go again. Lights, camera, action.
Boom.
Q stands alone at his school locker. It's been so long since his last visit that he struggles with his combination lock. When he finally gets it open, he pulls out a book and blows off the dust.
Sound like a porno.
When he closes the locker, slam, he sees Bishop standing there next to him.
What's up? Ain't seen you in a couple days. What's happening?
Q looks dead into his eyes, but gives no answer.
Man, get off that shit, man. It's over. Ain't nothing nobody could do right now.
What you want from me, man?
Nothing, man. Just came to see, make sure you was all right, dog. How you been doing?
Bishop puts his hand on Q's shoulder. He shrugs away and reacts in a loud tone.
Well, I ain't.
Then he whispers.
I ain't talked to nobody, nigga.
I know, man. We crew. Always will be. I just came to see what's up.
Let me tell you something, B. I'm only playing your game because that's the only shit else to do, but you won't ever pull a gun on me again in your life.
Well, I hope I don't have to.
Well, we all going down if you do, because we all crew, right? Just try me if you think I'm bullshitting.
Look at this, man. Brother finally decided to stand up like a man and throw down. Too bad Raheem had to die first. It's over. Everything starts from now. We all go down if we don't stand together. Ain't no man above the crew. You know that shit.
You crazy, man.
You know what? The last time you said that shit, I was kind of tripping, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? But now, you're right. I am crazy. But you know what else? I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck about you. I don't give a fuck about Steel. I don't give a fuck about Raheem. I don't give a fuck about myself.
Fade out.
Same. Yeah. Wait a minute. You missed the best Same. Part. You missed the best part.
What?
And you less of the man than me. Look, I ain't gonna never be shit. And you less of the man than me.
So when I say you ain't gonna be shit.
Booyah.
Finish it.
So be it. Because I'm the one y'all need to be worried about, partner. Look, that's my movie.
Partner.
It's in the house.
Partner. That's the
thing. And that's what that nigga did just
now. Partner.
Oh, that nigga got a hoodie.
Partner.
Nigga, partner. Nigga was on his Trayvon Martin, nigga.
Hey, nigga, you look, nigga, you was sounding too goddamn robotic for that. You got to put emotion in it, nigga, like. You're right, nigga.
Let's do it over with Rosebud.
Hell no.
Let's sing with Rosebud.
No, it'll turn into
sound
a
like
prison
that
scene.
Into a body. Yeah.
It's gonna turn into
a sound like you wanna get fucked, partner.
Yeah, meet me in jail, nigga. Meet me in jail.
This nigga right here was, look, this nigga was making it sound like a porno. He dusts it off, and he dusts it, and he turns it.
This nigga was talking like,
yeah, I'm like,
man, he went right into his porno voice, dude.
You better not read a book in the pen.
Bishop is by the locker with a dick in his hand.
Let me tell you something. That's why I never went to jail, cause I had a nigga get out of jail. He looked into my eyes and said, "Hey, nigga,
you
got some pretty eyes." Like, I am paying all my tickets.
No, look, like look, Valentine's.
That nigga on a level O yard and shit.
Yeah, like, look, I ain't never
had that nigga next to the security in the booth. Yeah, like, you sit here.
You know what?
Nigga.
You know what, my nigga, you stay at home, man.
You sit right here.
You do life at home.
Right.
He had that nigga opening gates and shit here.
Hey, see, but you don't know, look, like, this time
you
last year.
For us now.
This time last year, like, for Valentine's Day, like, they knew. I was in prison for Valentine's Day, and they was passing around chocolate and candy from cell to cell. Now, chocolate
shit.
Stood about 5'9" and had a ponytail, you know what I'm saying?
Ah,
and candy was a Mexican with implants.
Blam!
This nigga, dude, remembers every
chocolate
story,
chocolate and candy,
too.
Nigga. Chocolate and candy from cell to cell, nigga. Chocolate.
How do you know? I'm chocolate.
And the trustees got
I am chocolate.
Chocolate had a ponytail. Chocolate had a ponytail and candy
I
was a
I saw you when you came home and you cut your hair,
nigga. Too sweet.
And the trustees got chocolate and candy at the same time.
He the only nigga that could go back to prison without being arrested.
Yeah. I got a weekend pass, nigga.
Yeah, let that nigga in.
This nigga honorary celly. Like, let him in. This nigga finna turn it up.
This nigga got frequent flyer miles.
He finna stop all the violence in this nigga. Motherfucker.
Got prison keys on his
The pen on me
car.
Time, nigga.
Hey, look, now that nigga hard. He walk up to the gate and just do like this. And that motherfucker just
open
it.
Hey, everybody in the cell be like, chocolate, chocolate, chocolate. We want chocolate.
Wait a minute. We didn't start gay. We was on something else.
Okay.
We was on Raping Cowboy fans. We didn't right. y'all this go.
Yeah, you keep bringing up
song for that nigga. We want chocolate.
You keep bringing up prison
chocolate.
Shit.
Chocolate. It's like Raping Cowboy fans. I'm like, what the fuck?
Okay.
All right, look, what's some shit y'all niggas wouldn't do, man? Would y'all motherfuckers, would any nigga hang glide and shit? Hang glide.
I fuck around with hang glide.
Nigga do that shit?
Yeah, I had white friends. Nigga, hell yeah.
Man, that shit seemed fun, huh?
Yeah.
Get up there until you drop shit.
Yeah, well, motherfucker,
you gotta hold on tight.
You don't want.
Yeah, you gotta hold on tight than the motherfucker.
The only part is the nigga behind you holding you and shit like, hey, my nigga, loosen up.
Oh, wait, this nigga brought the gay shit in.
Hang glide.
rubbing off.
Look. Yeah, dude. Come on, Mellroz. Hey. We was talking about hang gliding,
I'm
dude.
I'm telling you, anytime you hang glide, it's a nigga holding you.
Everything black, white people did, niggas done it, but to a lesser degree. Like, instead of hang gliding, I used to jump off a roof with an umbrella. You know what I'm saying? Like... You ever try that shit?
Hell nah, nigga. That shit would break your ankles. This that nigga jump off the bunk bed.
I saw Batman. I saw the Joker do it.
That nigga jump off the bunk bed with a pillowcase.
You talking about a garage.
Why it went open?
I saw the Joker do it. So I just said, fuck it. I'm finna do it.
Look, all right. What about when niggas fuck with a hot air balloon, though?
Mm? Yeah, I've done that.
Oh, you done that?
Yeah,
this old romantic ass nigga.
Fuck on a hot air balloon?
Who done that? You done it?
I've been on a
hot air balloon. You a fuck on a hot air balloon?
This nigga been on a hot air balloon. Really?
What this is a Casanova like? Ass nigga right here.
Where the fuck was that exactly? Aspen and shit?
Where you was at? Never Neverland?
Yeah.
That shit in Paris, California, nigga. That nigga was in Paris.
Yeah, look, and why did you ever come down? Motherfucker, you should just be still up there.
I gotta go to work.
Nigga got a hot air condo.
He was like Boys in the Hood. Hey, let me out, Q.
This nigga was at Never Neverland in the-
I threw out that line, niggas don't know.
Yeah.
I don't shop.
And let me out.
I want out.
Oh, let me out, Trey.
Let me out.
Let me out, Doe.
Doe, let me out.
Drop a few sandbags, my nigga.
This nigga's crazy.
Nah, where'd you do that shit, though, man?
It was out there in Paris, California.
Yeah, that was Paris. That's some Paris shit. I already
like
know.
Like in the desert and shit?
No, yeah. It's in fields.
Oh, in fields?
Yeah.
Nigga, get a wine glass, get your girl in there, nigga.
You go to Napa?
This nigga did some old Valentine's shit.
That was Valentine's.
Okay, I got a question. Since Valentine's Day came on, what was the worst thing you have, the cheapest thing you ever bought a female for Valentine's Day? The cheapest shit.
I am the worst, dude.
The cheapest shit I've ever
done. I am literally the worst, dog.
I bought a glass, filled it full of M&Ms, and gave it to her.
Did she drink that motherfucker?
Hey, chocolate.
Oh, this nigga.
That nigga, that's
right
a prison shit. Nigga, was you in jail with this nigga?
Take these M&Ms, man. It's all I got.
I was like, fuck it.
That's a premium, motherfucker. That's like Patron candy.
I was 18 years old. I was like, fuck it, bitch.
It was thinking. It
this
was
nigga
a thought
said 18.
That count.
You nigga, that was 18 months ago, motherfucker.
Nah.
Cheapest shit I ever did was, I was probably about 23. I did a lollipop and a letter.
A lollipop and a letter. The big lollipop? The big lollipop?
It was handwritten.
And a letter?
And
what
letter.
Did a letter say, though?
Just some old fly Valentine shit. Some old Valentino.
That's too vague. That's too vague, nigga. What did it say?
I don't remember, nigga. I'm over 40 now. But what I did do was I took a lollipop and a letter, and I put it on the little windshield. It wasn't in my girl or nothing. I was crushing on her. I put the shit on there, and I saw her when she opened it, and she looked around, smiled.
Paper down.
She didn't even read it.
She read it. She read it. She smiled.
You should have took her picture when she smiled, too. Like, to capture, like, you was happy, like, goddamn it. You was happy.
Drove off licking the lollipop.
Oh, shit.
Some player shit.
And to go meet another nigga, right?
No, like, we've been married 16 years.
Hey, did you know though? Hey, did you write? Did
that
you,
move right there was so player
that she had to.
A week later, I was like, you know, that was me, right?
I never met another guy like you, Mellroz.
Yeah.
She put a letter, what you just wrote out the letter, look, this letter was self-destruct. You know what I'm saying? She's like, nigga.
You gotta get yourself room. A lot of niggas do too much too fast.
I am
with
the champion
a lollipop,
of that,
nigga,
man.
You got room to grow.
Oh, man. I am in reverse mode, nigga, every year, man. I'm dying a slow death, man.
Yeah, you started off too big.
I'm about to start buying myself shit, nigga.
This nigga went to college. She started doing all kind of extravagant.
Man, god damn,
shit.
Dude. It's rough, man.
I can see it.
I'm the type nigga that'll go to the store, right, with money in my fucking pocket, nigga, and walk all around that bitch and can't decide on what the fuck to get, nigga, and walk out and have
like,
nothing.
Like, damn, I got
dude.
This in, I
been
got
a
this
car,
in
like,
96.
I went in there to actually buy some shit, dude, and
but,
it's a full
for Valentine's
store.
Day?
Yes, man. It's painful. I don't know what it is, dude. I'm the worst.
You the worst.
I am the worst.
Now you just doing the tongue.
Ladies,
fool.
You don't want to fuck with a nigga like me if you like holidays.
Me and my baby mama, the baby daddy going to have one of her abortion for Valentine's Day.
This nigga said going half.
Going half.
You're a gentleman and yeah, shit.
I mean, I don't have to do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, come on.
No, hey,
I'm on GR. I ain't got to do that. You know what I'm saying? Right, if you're lucky, I'm doing that. We going half on it.
I mean, you could have went old school and just pushed your bitch down the stairs.
Again.
And all your uncles would look up to you and shit.
I done that last year.
Boy, you spending money?
Like, this nigga on his third baby pushed down the stairs. He like, I gotta do something more original this
hey,
year.
Hey, Trump, nigga, that shit is really
that
murder.
On the
that ain't an abortion, better... nigga. It's real murder.
You know what I'm gonna buy my baby mama? I'm gonna buy her 14 carrots for Valentine's Day. And she better eat every last one of them motherfuckers, too. Bitch, you better, I don't, my EBT, you better eat every 14 carat I buy.
Like a rabbit,
like
bitch.
Like a rabbit. I'm going to buy some Cristal, but it's going to be some Cristal light, bitch, you know what I mean?
And only use your front teeth.
Yeah, bitch. You're going to get some turn-ups for real.
14 carat, she going to see all the bullshit hey, for look, the rest of your life.
Hey, when do y'all start thinking about Valentine's Day?
February
13th. After Valentine's Day, nigga.
Like, goddamn, is it Valentine's Day?
That morning,
February 13th, I'd be like, shit.
I break up with all of them. Like, I make up excuses to break up with them before Valentine. Like, hold on, bitch, you got asthma? Wait a minute, I don't even think this is
you got asthma?
I don't know no goddamn, like, medical. You
what
got asthma?
Not, team
I
miss,
can't
miss?
Fuck
I need
with
a
you.
Motherfucker that can run down the street with me. With asthma, you can only run to the.
I was gonna take you to
Big Bear this weekend, yeah, bitch. But you can't handle that.
I ain't signed up for this, bitch. I don't know none of that CPR shit. I gotta go.
Asthma. Oh man, yeah. CPR.
You gotta make up
niggas
lies.
Know CPR. Who knows CPR? Did you learn that shit in jail, nigga?
Hell no.
Yeah.
I learned it
with
in county.
A shank.
Yeah, with a shank. Yeah, nigga's like, can you breathe, nigga? Can you breathe? I had to do that shit, though.
That nigga know how to do all shit in jail. Like, nigga, I want a grilled cheese. Hold on, my nigga.
With an iron, motherfucker. I know how to make it with an iron, nigga. I know how to make a shank out of lotion
Why
bottle.
Circles on my grilled cheese.
Oh, man.
Make a sink out of a lotion bottle, nigga.
This nigga know how to iron with the mattress. Like, damn, my nigga.
Nigga, this is...
No iron needed. No heat. You sleep on it, nigga.
Got no starch or nothing.
Damn, this nigga got the jailhouse khakis.
Hey, let me tell you about my homie, right? This nigga, dude, is the smartest, dumbest-ass criminal nigga ever, right? Like, he like a master criminal, but then the nigga, like, masterfully gets caught, right? Let me tell you this fool, Doug. He think he's like an innovator. Right. This motherfucker came up with the idea to like, he said like, yeah, fool. So what I do is I go up to like Best Buy where it's crowded and everybody moving around. And then I watch a lady pull in the Benz or whatever. Boom, boom, boom. And when she get out her shit, I kind of walk towards the car. And when she get out and before she hit the chirp, nigga, I open the back door and get in her shit and close the door while she go chirp, chirp. And she locked me in there, man. I'm like, oh, damn, man, fuck, that's kind of genius and shit. Well, how the fuck you get caught? Niggas like, I was waiting in the car for her to come and unlock the shit so I can get out, dude.
Okay, first of all, let me tell you something. When you're a criminal and you keep getting caught, maybe crime ain't what the fuck you need to do.
No, motherfucker.
Practice make perfect, nigga.
I got a brother in jail. I got a brother.
Don't discourage criminals, nigga.
Yeah, some niggas need to be discouraged.
I got a brother.
We
got to
start. Thin in the herd.
I got a brother in jail right now for robbing a free clinic. And he's trying to sell the ship at half price. He got caught for trying to sell the ship at half price.
Nigga said robbing a free clinic.
Wait.
What's your uncle's name, dude?
Calvin.
Mr. Calvin, man. I know you got some jail tales, huh, over there, man.
Hell no.
See, like, he
tails.
Got a whole flock over in there, dude.
Don't bring my uncle in here.
Hell no. Calvin ain't been to jail.
Y'all want
to
hear some real
tales? Nah, he too sick.
Hell no.
Y'all want to hear some real tales of the tale? Nah.
My Uncle Calvin. First of all, they don't understand. My Uncle Calvin is...
He's from Texas.
I love him. Yeah, he's from Texas. I'm from Texas, and I love my uncle.
Is everything being in Texas like they
hey,
say?
Hey, man, you know how to cook.
Okay. Shit.
Hey, he looks like he could cook some mean barbecue.
You just got sized up by the nigga next to you.
This nigga, man, I don't know, dude.
This nigga sized you up.
You say enough gay jokes, nigga. No, that shit is real, motherfucker.
I just said it's everything.
There's truth to every joke,
I just said it's everything big in Texas.
I ain't never been.
What are we talking about, dude?
I'm post-scared straight, nigga. Like, I'm past the age. age of being scared straight yet. This nigga is scaring me straight
I
again.
I know, man.
Hey, you just turned into a nigga boyfriend. On air.
We go together.
I saw it happen.
You saw the movie Friday?
Hey, POTUS, do y'all have like a psychology show and shit coming up next?
You saw the movie next Friday?
This nigga need intervention.
Yeah, he need
You saw the movie next Friday?
This nigga hand finna touch your thigh, nigga.
Who was the first thing that they said to Money Mike?
I have no idea.
I don't know.
You ever been to the pen, homie?
This nigga, man.
Out.
God damn. Out.
Why is this motherfucker?
Man, dude, they have him in a special ward.
Why is this nigga next to you?
This nigga's like a prison predator and shit.
I bet you this nigga's house is set up like the yard.
I'm getting my penitentiary workouts every morning. Drink my coffee.
That nigga got a
bunk in
him. Motherfucker
going to his room and be like, he yell out, "Closed cell number 10.
That nigga got a bunk in a pro style jail bucket of Vaseline.
Nigga got a Costco size. Nigga like
he got the Costco Vaseline
years,
on.
And I want one bucket.
He walked around. He walked by his baby's crib and said, "Yo, my nigga, get used to that."
Speaking of gay,
it runs in the family.
No, speaking of gay, this not gay, but I got some gay questions, but it's not gay.
Started off gay.
No, wait a minute.
It's major gay.
No, wait a minute. Okay.
It's okay to be gay, dude. You should just say it. That's all we saying, dude. That's
okay.
All I'm saying.
Okay, let's go with this gay
first
question.
Right?
All right, first question.
Have you ever had a massage in one of the massage chairs with the dollar for the 5 minutes?
No.
You ever have
at the mall? And
at
shit?
The mall, you know what I'm saying? You ever see how it be doing your back?
It be dudes though.
And then,
dudes. Have you done it?
But it's one part of the.
Of course he has.
Done it. He did the massage, nigga.
No,
he told that nigga lay down. I'm pissed.
He saw that nigga a mile away. It was like, hey.
Hey, nigga, you got supple hands.
I'm talking about.
He told your Chinese nigga lay down. I'm paying for this.
Hey, nigga, how your feet feel, nigga? You need a foot massage?
Hey, nigga, kept that nigga off the escalator. Like, there's one.
Hey, the Chinese nigga said, "Where'd you get the oil from?"
No. Look, he hit him with the black.
No.
Is that black?
No.
Black from Folsom?
No, I'm talking about the chair.
Chocolate?
The massage chair.
Chocolate?
No. Oh, you're talking about the chair.
The chair.
Oh.
Where to do your back, you know what I'm saying?
Ain't nobody in it. It's just the chair.
And then they got a blue part that goes in your ass.
Okay. No, I ain't never had that.
That was a Chinese nigga. That wasn't part of the chair, nigga.
Fucking talking about
that was a real hand, my nigga.
I'm just saying, they should tell you, like you should have an option. Like, I don't want the massage chair to go in my ass. Like, it's a little ball that goes.
Oh, man.
I have an option.
I never seen that function on the chair.
Okay, well.
Nigga sitting in regular chairs, motherfucker, with hard bottoms.
This motherfucker be sitting in chairs with holes in the bottom.
Yeah. With air pockets and shit.
Well, I got one more question. Okay, if I'm watching a porn and my homie called me and
man.
I answer the phone, is that if I'm in the middle of doing my thing and I answer the phone, is that like
that's gay, man?
Nigga, that's perfect timing for niggas like you.
Exactly.
That nigga still be talking like, "What's up, my nigga?
You was feeling me, nigga.
Everything
you was
cool. Feeling me. Everything cool right here."
He be talking to his homie. Hey, my nigga, what you wearing right now?
Yeah. Your ears must be ringing.
nigga.
Hey, baby, this Jack from State Farm.
What you wearing? Khakis?
Khaki shorts? You got on khaki shorts?
Say that again, but slower.
Nigga wear like denim condoms and shit.
Y'all took this the wrong way.
How else can we take it, nigga? The way you
fucking jail tales.
Hey man, we got about 2 minutes left, brother.
Hey dude,
there are ladies in here and they are like scared. Like they like.
No, they like he ain't gonna do shit to us, girl. We straight.
Yeah,
this nigga like them niggas up there. We cool.
Yeah, motherfucker, it's us, nigga.
Them motherfuckers can walk around in thongs. They be like,
we gotta walk out.
We cool.
This nigga ain't tripping on us.
We gotta go single file.
A nigga in boxers though. Got problems going to the car.
Hey, we gotta stick together.
Yeah, nigga, I need somebody to walk me to the car.
Let this nigga out the gate first, my nigga. Where that clicker at?
I thought it was out the closet.
Oh man, don't y'all need to parole this nigga? Somebody.
This nigga got a parole.
This nigga parole officer don't even fuck with him. Like, no, nah, I ain't sitting one-on-one with that nigga.
I ain't going to bend over and squat, my nigga. I just need the piss. You don't need to bend over and squat. It's a piss test, my nigga. Don't bend over and spread them, my nigga. We just take a piss
test. This nigga parole officer deal with him on the phone. Like, yeah, you good? You straight? You straight? You at the house? Okay, we cool.
But look, on his last day,
Skype him.
On his last day, the nigga be getting out, and he be like, I'm not going. I'm gonna stay. All right, man. Nah, we gotta get out of here, y'all, man. It's been an hour.
Yeah.
This has been straight clowning. Anyway, let's go around, man. Tell me who you are and what you got coming up next, man. Let's do it.
Mellroz, man, I'm gonna say this live right now. In 2 weeks, man, I'm opening up my barbershop, 89 West, man. Look out for that, man.
Hey, man.
Everything been happening, you know what I'm saying? So, boom.
Heterosexual patrons only.
If you gay,
no secret
don't
shampoos,
say
nigga.
Yeah, exactly. I'm Mike Robertson. Thanks for joining Mike Robertson Boulevard. Find me at King Mike Boogie on everything, you know what I'm saying? B, baby. Yo, quick.
Oh, Willis Turner. You can catch me at Twitter on Willis Turner 1. And also, I'm shooting a short film.
Oh, shit. We should have talked about that. Come back, man. We're going to talk about that. Black, quick.
Black Rosebud. I'm trying to shoot my baby mama, but I'm taking a break off. You know what I'm saying? Doing a little writing. I'm going to come back out with my radio show, probably on this radio station.
And
I'm saying the Black Rosebud Uncensored show is coming back in May. We're going to revoke it. We're going to redo it. You know what I'm saying?
Let's do it, y'all. Hey, King Mike Boogie. Oops. Chirp.
About to sign out and niggas having fun. You can see me, I be chilling in the sun.
Patricia
never
television.
Had a gun.
Oh, keep going.
And I got EBT for sale.
Male, Rose.
We're
from
on
the
it.
Grave to the slave. Everybody know I misbehave.
And I do it
for a living. You can see me on the floor from the ceiling to the ceiling.
Okay. What are you doing?
EBT.
This nigga getting naked.